Do you remember the Volkswagen Beetle? The best-selling car of all time. In production since 1938 until 2003. Affordable, reliable, and it did what it was supposed to do. Safely take you from point A to point B. What would be the equivalent in the general aviation world? Of course, that is the Cessna 172 Skyhawk. The Cessna 172 is the most successful aircraft in history. It is made by Cessna Aircraft Company, now a Textron Aviation Company. The first production model was delivered in 1956 and is still in production today with more than 44,000 units built. I will repeat this again, 44,000. It is a single-engine aircraft. You'd normally find a Continental 0300, a six-piston engine that produces 180 horsepower. The plane has a high wing configuration, which makes it very stable in flight but also provides its occupants better visibility to the ground. The Cessna 172 is ubiquitous in the general aviation world. It is robust and versatile to accomplish many tasks. Tasks that might be considered impossible or even illegal. Cessna has similar model designs, like the 150 and its newer version, the 152, which is featured in the Microsoft Flight Simulator with incredible detail. Older models include the Cessna 120, 140, 142, 170, 180, and, well, you get the idea. There are many models that have a similar shape. But the most famous and popular is the 172, which also has over 20 variations, plus some special ones. But the current one still in production today is the 172S Skyhawk. It comes with a glass cockpit using a Garmin G1000, a reliable avionics system that replaces analog gauges, although pilot students must learn how to fly using the classic needle indicators since they're still present in many aircraft today. Hold on, what the hell is that? Anyways, even though the G1000 is a reliable piece of avionics, the 172 also includes the analog counterparts of the speed indicator, attitude indicator, and the altimeter for redundancy. Part of the history of this emblematic aircraft is the world record made by Robert Timm and John Cook in 1959. Flying in a modified Cessna 172 for more than 64 days, covering an estimated 150,000 miles or 240,000 kilometers. I'll represent how much is 240,000 kilometers here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 6 times going around the Earth. Before them, in 1958, there was another record made by two pilots named Jim Heath and Bill Burkhart in Dallas, Texas. They flew for 50 days, also using a Cessna 172. To break the record, Robert and John had to fly 4 days longer. Some of the main modifications done to the aircraft to endure this flight were the replacement of the engine for a brand new one, the addition of a 95-gallon belly tank paired with an electric pump that could transfer fuel to the main wing tanks, special plumbing that could allow engine oil and filters to be changed while the engine was still running, the interior was stripped out, and the standard co-pilot's door was also removed and replaced with a folding-style accordion door instead. A platform was also rigged up that could be extended out of the co-pilot's side of the aircraft. This allowed the co-pilot some additional room to move during the crucial refueling operations, reaching out to clean the windshield, and to have enough space to take a shower with a bottle of water. They also put a little sink for shaving and toothbrushing. They refueled the aircraft from a moving truck while flying. The refueling took about 3 minutes, and it was done twice a day. The pickup truck and the plane had to match their speed every time in a deserted stretch of road for about 3 whole minutes to accomplish this. The pilots took turns of 4 hours to fly the plane while the other could sleep. And the flight was sponsored by Las Vegas Hacienda Hotel, who provided $100,000 for this project. Approaching the day 40, their generator failed. The engine could still run, but the plane had no heat, lights, or even autopilot. When they reached the 50 days mark, they broke the record, but they decided to press on to make the record last. About 2 weeks later, still in the air, they couldn't go on farther due to mechanical wearing of the engine. Carbon was building up in the combustion chambers, making the engine become weaker. Gaining altitude was almost impossible at this point. So, after 64 days, 22 hours, 19 minutes, and 5 seconds, they landed the plane, making the new world record for refueled flight endurance on February 7, 1959. The 172 is the aircraft of choice for pilot schools. It is stable in flight, and one of its great features is its tricycle landing gear, which makes the aircraft easier to land. The unobstructed ground visibility and the rear window feature, called Omnivision, are also good selling points. The wings of a Cessna 172 uses a NECA 2412 aerofoil. This is a specific shape of the profile of the wing that will have different aerodynamic characteristics depending on the aerofoil, also called airfoil. These characteristics vary depending on the different shapes that are carefully designed with mathematical models. Some are made to fly more efficiently at higher speeds, others are designed to produce more lift at lower speeds, and many more combinations. The NECA 2412 aerofoil used in the Cessna 172 can operate at the middle of its envelope, remaining stable and reacts more quickly to changes in speed. It also has lift and drag with smoother variations during changes in angle of attack at approach speeds, making landings easier. Talking about speed, this plane cruises at 122 knots or 226 km per hour. It cannot ever exceed 163 knots or 302 km per hour. And its stall speed is 47 knots or 87 km per hour, equivalent to 54 miles per hour, with the power off and full flaps down. That's a good soft and slow landing speed. Is it safe to fly on a Cessna 172? Of course, but also, it depends. Like any other aircraft, Cessna's 172 come out of the factory after testing and quality checks to ensure its reliability. You might know already that statistically it is safer to fly on airplanes than to drive a car on the streets. And being one of the most popular aircraft out there says something about the safety of this plane. However, when the plane has many hours of operation, maintenance is required. Another thing is the pilot. Its skills also account for a huge part of flying safely. Judging the right conditions, knowing how to respond in different situations, understanding the plane, and all those skills make the difference. So if a combination of all those things are in a good level of confidence, nothing should go wrong. In the same way, if someone drives an old car with poor service done to the engine and other parts, on top of that the driver is impatient and doesn't respect the traffic rules or is simply not trained correctly, that's when accidents happen, no matter what vehicle you use. And although a lot of accidents happen with this aircraft, that doesn't mean that the plane is not safe. That just means that a lot of people have these planes, and it is a statistical inevitability that some have accidents. In the end, the Cessna 172 is an iconic flying machine of our current times, until one day we don't need propellers anymore. Thank you so much for watching this video until the end, I really appreciate that. Please go ahead and show your support by subscribing to this channel. And also check out my new channel, which is perfect for people who like philosophy, inspirational videos, or in the path of searching for your own truth, and similar topics. I'll leave the link in the description below.